Hello friends, how are you all? Today in this video I am going to show you how to install side stand sensor switch in Apache RTR 180. This bike is 2010 model. So friends, why I decided to install this safety switch for the side stand? As you know, a lot of road accidents are happening because of this stand when it's open while driving the motorcycle. So for this arrangement I'm going to use this switch and this sensor. This switch and sensor is coming in Splendor, HERO Splendor, and I have taken it from the HERO. For this switch is for 120 rupees and this sensor is for 37 rupees. So these two things I am taking. This is called sensor and this is called switch. It will be fixed. This switch will be fixed over here. It will be fixed over here. Here. And the arrangement will be like this. Like this. It will be mounted on the side stand rod. It will be moving like this. There is magnetic terminals over here. As you can, it already sticked. There is magnet in this notch. There are magnetic terminals. When this notch comes over here, it breaks the contact of these two wires. And when the stand is engaged, it will be like this, and the light and the circuit will be completed, and the light will be on. So first of all, you have to remove the side stand of Apache RTR. And in this case, I have done some changes to this sensor. I have removed some particle part from here, and I have made this triangle shape because it's not coming correctly on the stand. So it will be fixed like this, and simply I have to mount it like this and fix the bolt. I have to mark the location of this switch. I have to finalize the location. I have connected the two terminals of this switch with the multimeter so that I can hear the continuity. Right now the connections are short, so that's why beep of sound is coming. As soon as magnet will go near to the sensor, the beep will automatically off. As you can see, the alert will automatically off. So for marking, I will keep the switch over here and try to see. As you can see friends, as you can hear and see friends, as soon as this nodal, the magnet is going near to the switch, the beep sound switch is off. Still, right now the stand is not fully closed, fully upside. So still I have some angle to go up. Means this mounting will be sufficient. This range is sufficient for me to mount the switch. To mount the switch, I have to make this hole and one small hole over here. This hole, this notch type hole into this metal. As you can see friends, two holes. One hole is here for the plastic notch, one hole is here for the screw of the switch. Is already done, as you can see over here. Now you can see. I will fix the switch. So as you can see friends, the switch is on its place now. Switch is very well on its place and the range is also perfect. I will connect the multimeter to show you the working of this switch. the stand will go till here when it will be equipped with the spring. With this spring, the stand will go till here, and the beep sound, the alert will be switched off from this angle till that angle, as you can see approximately 10 degrees. So the switch is on its place, as you can see. Now next concern is to how to take the wires from here to the instrument cluster, so where I can connect the switch, alert switch, and the buzzer. The buzzer I have taken from the TVS OEM supplier. This is a buzzer. This I have taken for 99 rupees. This buzzer actually fits in Jupitor, so I think OEM accessory will always be helpful and work very fine. So I'm going to install buzzer. So if I am not giving attention to the light, at least the buzzer will be on, so that I can hear the audible siren and take up the stand. So as far as this wiring routing concern, I have removed the cover. This is the this is a chain socket where the chain is coming. This is the small sprocket where the chain is coming. This cover I have taken from here. So at any cost, I am not going to take the wire from here like this, no, because these are all moving parts. It may damage the wire, or by mistake, or unfortunately, if the wire will come into contact with this thing, it will immediately damage the wire. So I will take the wire from here. I will take it from here. I will take it from the downside, then I will take it. So as you can see the gap after behind this plate where my finger is touching, behind that plate I will take it, and I will take it from here, from that opening. Okay, then I mount it here, then I will continue the wiring works as shown. See, as you can see friends, here there is no moving parts and the wire will go very safely. Moreover, the company has given this fire rated, and to prevent this wire from the external forces or external damage, they have provided some sleeve which is which serves for the protection of the wire. So nothing will happen to that wire, only I have to mount it with the proper adequate size of cable ties, removable cable ties. As you can see, there also one cable tie is there. This is removable cable tie, same I will use at every point to keep the wire stable and away from the moving parts. So I will proceed for the electrical wiring works. As you can see friends, now I have installed the spring of the stand, I tightened the switch, tightened the sensor to its place. So now it's the time to finally check the action of the stand with the spring when it will be pulled. So I have connected the switch with the this multimeter. Right now the circuit is complete. You can see the buzzer is on. Buzzer is in the inside this multimeter. So later on I will install this buzzer which will indicate me. Okay, so right now the stand is open and indication buzzer is on. As soon as I will pull this stand with my feet up, it will switch off. As you can see friends, it's working very fine. The range of the switch is very perfect. As soon as it crosses the edge nearby this circuit, it starts beeping. So the installation of the switch and the sensor is done. Now remaining part is the routing of the wire, that I have already explained to you. Then I will finish it, then I will show it. Okay, so friends, now the wiring has been pulled from the side stand switch till here. As you can see, this is the grip of the same switch, and now we are going to install the buzzer. So friends, as you can see, I have installed the buzzer over here. This is the only place, safest place, where the water will not enter and damage this buzzer. It should be installed on the place where the water should not directly splash on that. So I got this location. As you can, this is the instrument cluster meter assembly. Below that I got one screw, as you can see, this one where my thumb is touching. This screw, this holds the meter with this panel, so I have loosened that one, and as you can see, the fitting is very proper. As you can see, this is the spacer which is directly sitting on the, which is completely sitting on the surface of the panel, and the buzzer is on its place, so it will not vibrate or loosen or move from its place. So this is the coupler in this buzzer. This buzzer is taken from the Jupitor, TVS Jupitor. The purple is negative, and this one brown, this one is positive, and green is also positive. That is for right side indicator, left side indicator. So I have to connect only purple with the negative, and any of the wire from this green and brown with the phase which is coming through the switch installed at the stand. So the this other side grip is already, it's also ready to be installed. So I will install it in the flexible cable to prevent the wire from the external forces. So now friends, buzzer is already installed. As you can see, on the wiring of the buzzer I have installed the flexible cable, I have installed the flexible pipe on the cables of buzzer, and after that it's connected to the grip. Okay, and the grip is traveling all the way around from here behind the meter. See, this blue taped wiring is for the buzzer. So one negative wire that is white in this, in my extension it's white, and in the buzzer it's purple. So this will directly connected to the negative terminal of the battery, and after that one wire, this blue wire, this will go to the orange of CDI unit. Why I have selected orange? Because this is the only wire, whenever I will switch on the supply, like whenever I will switch on the bike, the this orange will be energized. When the switch will be closed, will be off, this there will be no supply in this orange. So I have done the tapping with the orange wire. I am not doing any cutting of the factory fitted wire. Just I am wrapping and taking out the thimble from the grip, away from the grip, and tapping the new wire, additional wire onto that. So after that, actually this blue wire is going to the, this blue wire is taking supply 12 volt, and it's traveling all the way around. At the back side you can see this grip, and it's going to the switch. From that, from the phase is going to the switch, it's coming here. Whenever the stand will be down, it will pass the signal and the buzzer will be on. Whenever the switch is like closed like this, then it will not pass the circuit from here to the other side. As you can see that this returning one phase is returning in this blue tapping, and it's going to this T junction, and again it's going to the beeper buzzer. So in this way, right now I have to connect, put the thimble on that one and connect it to the negative terminal, and here also wherever I have done the tapping, I will solder it properly so that it should not loosen, and after that I will put the glue gun with the glue gun so as to make the contacts properly insulated, and mechanically there should be complete bonding. So after finalizing, I will show you the complete detail. Friends, as you can see, I have completely soldered the additional wire. Here you can see the wire is completely soldered, so there is no chance for the wire to escape outside this grip. So the grip is here. This is a single wire grip with which the I will put the grip onto the thimble, then I will tighten it with the silicone with the glue so that it should be water sealed. So friends, grip is already at its place. Right now only the negative terminal is balanced. I will temporarily join it and I will show you how it will work. It's connected, supply is on. I am just pulling the side stand, as you can see. Now alert is there. As soon as I will pull it upside, the buzzer will switch off. As you can see, friends, I haven't used any wire. I haven't run any wire which is exposed. Everything in the switch side and the buzzer side, I have used the proper grips so that in case of removal, I can remove all the things easily. As you can see friends, the switch is fixed on its place very properly, and the sensor is also placed on its place very properly. Again, I will open the stand. As you can see, the buzzer is on. If I have to add the light in the instrument cluster over here, simply I have to tap with the connections of the buzzer. So as you can see friends, bike is ready. I have assembled all the things whatever I have removed. So now the side stand is closed. Now I will switch on the bike, let it start, scan. Now as you can see, I will, the beeper is there behind this visor. So this was all about how to install side stand indication alert sensor in the Apache RTR 180. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.